Hey guys, what's going on? I want to do an update video on an update that came out the other day for release 3.8.5. There really wasn't a lot of information about it, so I wanted to wait till there was actually some other information that was worth going over, and well, we have all of that. So we have update 3.8.5 that was released and downloaded the other day for use. With that, we also got some legal stuff about privacy sharing and all that other information. I'm actually going to save that for another video and another discussion because I need to look further into it. To keep it short, from what I read through the Reddit post, and again, don't take this for fact. This is just what I read. I don't know how true it is. I need to do the research. From what I understand is Bandai had put out a notice saying you either will accept the terms or you will no longer be allowed to use the services. So you either need to accept the their terms of service in order to allow for data sharing. Otherwise, you will be the services for the game will be suspended. Otherwise, it'll be automatically agreed. So I don't know how that's going to play. I'm going to have to wait and find out. I'm going to have to do some more research about that to see how true that is and how legally binding that is. It might be a loophole. We'll have to wait and see. But anyway, that was announced for this. And it also came out for Dragon Ball Legends. It also came out, I believe, for Naruto's games and stuff like that. So keep that in mind. But again, that's going to be set for a separate. In terms of the download, we have other information. Lots of translations came in, and we have all the, as we probably already know if you have logged in today, we have the LR Super Saiyan 3 Goku, the Super Saiyan 3 Bardock, and the Tapion stuff that is coming along. So we have all that stuff. It's all translated, which is really awesome. We also have the new story event that's going to be coming out. Categories that were released were Movie Boss Category, Giant Form, Namek Saga, Ginyu Force, and Pure Saiyan. What was there last time? World Tournament Card Dokkans were untranslated. Agility Super Saiyan 3 GT Goku and Super Saiyan 3 GT Vegeta were untranslated. Dragon Ball Heroes cards, Super Saiyan 3 Gohan, Toa, and Super Saiyan 3 Trunks. So right now, we don't know what's going on. We don't know if we're going to get Heroes, though they have a whole bunch of Hero stuff going on. Maybe they finally got some approval to allow for Heroes to be on the global side, or whatever the actual legal stuff was behind that, whether they wanted to actually release them or not. So anyway, we might be getting Heroes at some point, which I kind of hope we do, especially with the Super Saiyan 3 coming along. Those other two Super Saiyan 3s, especially that Gohan and that Trunks, really awesome units. That Trunks is such a good blocker. And Gohan, I mean, I don't have him go all crazy and whatnot on my JP side, but he does hit pretty decently. Remember, that's also like base dupe system. I'm not sure if I got Attack 10. So I am kind of hoping that they come along. But anyway, he will be here. Let's go ahead and talk about it. This is from the in-game announcement. By the way, shout out to the Reddit. Shout out to DB Space for all the information, as always. So here we have the Super Saiyan 3 Warrior Special Campaign that are coming. So the first one is going to be the login bonuses, which we're going to talk about in a minute. They started today at login. We also have special mission rewards that are going to be coming out. Dragonstone sales, they're already here, so if you guys want to go purchase Dragonstone sales, I know some of you had already posted up in the Facebook group that you purchased all of them because you're all excited about Super Saiyan 3 Bardock. I'm not going to lie to you. I'm really excited for Super Saiyan 3 Bardock myself. I would love to pull Super Saiyan 3 Bardock. We're going to talk about that too in a minute. We do have the Wrath of Dragon Rising Carnival. Get a multi-summon and get two Elder Kais. Now, I don't know if I want to summon on this banner. I don't want to summon on this banner. But this banner should contain the LR Super Saiyan 3 Goku, which is a freaking beast. He is a phenomenal unit. I would love to get that unit. I really would love it. It's going to be out actually in a couple hours. The other thing is I don't really hunt for LRs, so I don't want to summon on this banner because I think the banner is garbage. Even the Tapion, I'm not a big fan of him. So he's a cool unit to have if you like the transformations. But outside of those, guys, I don't think you should summon on that banner. That's just like the beginning of the video. Don't summon on the banner. I don't think it's worth it. We have the the new Dokkan event that's coming out, so you can Dokkan Awaken your Tapion. And then the Wrath of the Dragon story event, which then I would definitely recommend grinding that out. That's going to be some fun. Let's see. Dokkan events available daily for the following events will be available. Surpassing All, Unparalleled Paragon of Hope. So essentially all the OG 70% leaders are going to be available every day, which is really weird that they have all of them available. Unrivaled Ultimate Fusion as well. So it looks like they're going to have a whole bunch of cool stuff that's going to be available. Challenge these Dokkan events to collect wards. So the Super Saiyan 3 Bardock banner, it looks like instead of getting Revived Frieza, which makes sense because he just came out, It looks like we are going, or he was just on a recent banner. Looks like they may have replaced him with Omega Shenron. I'm not upset. I definitely need some dupes for my Omega Shenron, so I'm kind of happy about that. Unfortunately, this doesn't look like it's going to drop until June 3rd, so next Sunday, not this coming Sunday, the following Sunday it looks like it's going to be available. So I will be at work when this, well, I will actually probably be home when that drops, but I'll probably be sleeping when it drops. So I will try to do a recording Monday morning before I go into work of summons, unless I just can't sleep, and then I'll probably just go and do some summons that night. We have the new Dokkan event that obviously would accompany it. We also have this Bardock event that's coming, the Lone Warrior's Last Battle. Chance to get up to four characters, don't grind it out, just do the basic stuff, just do the all the medals. That's really about it. I guess that Bardock is to be cool if you want to try to grind him out for the future LR Bardock. Don't know if you want to try and do that, but I wouldn't recommend doing it. I think it's just coming out because it's a Bardock card, so that's about it in terms of stuff. Oh, and let's see, the rates of success are tripled, so that's pretty cool. So you have all this cool stuff that's up in terms of login bonuses. The first, you have daily missions, clear any quest 3 times, you get a Dragon Stone. Clear any stage 3 times under a special condition. You get 10 times of these Baba Shop treasures. So I think the special condition is having a Super Saiyan 3 member on your team. That's not that hard to do. There's a lot of Super Saiyan 3 members in the game. If you haven't pulled one, well, I'm sorry. I think the Super Saiyan 3 Angel Goku, he is technically free to play, just a lot of Dokkaning. He should meet the requirements for that. So you could use him and he is technically free to play. He's from the Epic Showdown event and you need to Dokkan Wake him to Agility Angel. Then you Dokkan Wake him again to like Super Saiyan. Then he goes to Super Saiyan 2, I believe. Revived Super Saiyan 2 and then Super Saiyan 3. So have fun with that. That will be a thing. Weekly missions resets every Thursday. Consume 33 stamina, 133 and 333 for a total of 6 stones, which you should definitely be doing. Time limited missions, Z awaken a character 1 and 3 times for awakening medals, Dokkan awaken a character for 2 reverse Dokkans, Dokkan awaken 3 characters for Elder Kai's, beat certain Dokkan events 3 times, 5 times, 10, 20, and 33 times for an Elder Kai, 8 Dragon Stones, some training items, and some cool other items. Definitely worth most of these. I mean, the Elder Kai definitely, especially if you're free to play, you definitely want to try and get as many of those free to play ones as you can. So that's pretty cool, and you're going to want to go ahead and do that. Personally, I got my Frieza up to Super Attack 6 right now. I used the 2 Grand Elder Kais, the Revive Frieza. I got to use 2 Grand Elder Kais and 3 of the Strength Angel Friezas. I don't have any more Awakening Medals, so I'm probably going to end up using 4 Elder Kais on. But we'll have to wait and see. Maybe if we get some more Grand Elder Kais, I'll use. Anyway, story event coming. We already talked about that, and the Wrath of the Dragon story event is going to be here. These are all the new units that are becoming out between either 5/24 and 6/03, so June 3rd. So the Wrath of the Dragon event, you have a whole bunch of units, like the Great Saiyan Man stuff. I think Hoi's part of the actual banner. These are all going to be on the banner. The Goku, the LR, this Goku that goes to this LR Super Saiyan 3 Goku, which is such an awesome unit. We will probably talk about all these units. I already did this on the JP side, but I will redo a team building guide for everyone. So that way you can meet along with the global side, because there's going to be some differences, especially if we don't get the heroes. So, you know, stay tuned for all of that information when I do that. I don't think the giant category requires me to do another video, just because they're the same across both sides. Plus, I mean, there's not that many transformation units in game. So, I mean, just look at your category and see what you could bring. I typically talk about them anyway. There's like 4 or 5 really decent units that you could run on that team. I mean, just go look at my past videos about it and you'll definitely be able to figure out. If not, if you guys ask for it, maybe I'll do it again moving forward. And this is going to be the Tapion banner over here. So this is what was available on the one from the JP side. Now this Super Saiyan Goku has eluded me. He has eluded me for the longest time. I still don't have him. I kind of want to get him. I don't know if I'm going to summon for it. But this banner doesn't really have a lot of phenomenal units. I will say that this Korra over here, he's a good support unit. This Turles over here is a good support unit, kind of a staple. And actually, both of them are kind of staples on Mono Extreme Intelligence team, if that's your thing, if you like running Kid Buu. So if you don't have them, maybe that you'll want to consider that. This Gohan, I never really run him. He is a Kid Gohan. He is going to be farmable in the future, in the near future, most likely. And the one thing about him, he's like the Agility Whis, where he will be able to recover all of your health 1 time when your HP drops, I believe, below 30%. So he might come in handy for certain events, maybe like Super Battle Road, he'll help you out. But that's the only thing he's worthwhile for. And then you have the two Tapions, and honestly, I'm not a big fan of them. I believe the Super Saiyan 3 Goku was made available on this banner. So if you want to summon on it, it looks like we're getting the two Elder Kais except for Santa Roshi's on the JP side. We should be getting the regular Elder Kais, and that's about it. I mean, other than that, I mean, there were the other LRs on this banner, so I don't know. Maybe I'll do it for some of the Elder Kais. Maybe I'll do like two or three summons, like one video's worth of summons, and we'll see what happens with that. I don't really know, though. LR Bojack's there, and I wouldn't mind getting LR Bojack. So, again, we'll have to wait and see. I don't really think you guys should summon on this banner. I really don't, unless you have a big thing for Tapion, but, I mean, I'm not a big fan. Anyway, moving on for the JP side, I want to talk about. JP side, you had Super Saiyan 3 Angel Goku and Golden Angel Frieza on the banner. Now, we did see Omega Shenron, so chances are the Revive Frieza is going to be taken off. The other units, notable units, is going to be the Super Saiyan 3 Angel Goku, which does make sense because he's going to be on the banner. The Vegeta Blue, Trunks, which I still don't have him on Global, goddamn. The Tank Vegeta, Janemba, and the physical Super Saiyan Goku, and the Agility Bardock. Now, the Agility Bardock's going to stay there because he gets a Dokkan Awakening. And his Dokkan Awakening is pretty cool. His Dokkan Awakening will also increase the super attack of the Super Saiyan 3 Bardock. So I'm definitely going to do 4 Dupaz of this guy, of the Agility one, and then all the extra ones that I have, I'm going to increase the super attack of the Super Saiyan 3 one. Maybe we'll see what happens. Maybe I don't want to go through that grind. I'll have to wait and see. That's probably what's going to happen with me. In terms of this banner was awesome. All these units are still really good. Janemba obviously is being replaced by his strength counterpart on most teams, but he's still a staple on a mono intelligence team. I have mine 100% it. He definitely does a lot of damage. He's a really good unit, and he tanks everything. Vegeta obviously is still a tank. Trunks, not so much, unless you have like an LR Gohan. I do want to run him alongside that LR Gohan if I was to pull him. He's a good unit. He's an orb changer, so it definitely makes that LR Gohan great. Vegeta, again, mono intelligence. He's actually going to be a primary unit that you're going to run for Vegeta, Vegeta Blue, on every team that he's good for, until the new agility one comes out, and that's if you pull him. And then obviously the top three over here, which is probably going to be these two and the Omega. So I'm definitely going to be summoning on this banner. I'm probably going to go ham. But we'll have to see. Also, in some housekeeping news, we had achieved first place rank. We got 14 stones and 3,000 intelligence orbs. So that's a thing. So that's pretty awesome. We got a couple other stones refunded for certain units and whatnot. So just go in, log into both the JP and the global side and collect everything that you need to. I mean, obviously, most of us are going to be daily logins anyway. So I would just recommend jumping in and doing your daily login stuff. Over here, shout out to the Reddit. We're back over on the Reddit. Patara medals are also in the Baba shop. So now you could purchase the Baba shop or the Patara earrings from the Baba shop. That's great because I want to use the rest of the stones. I never actually got the medals to Dokkan Wake in my Vegito. So now I'm probably going to go and just buy them with the Baba shop stuff, because I want to use it on stamina. I want to increase the stamina in the game. So that's probably what I'm going to end up doing. So that's awesome. So that's going to be cool. And then we also have information from the JP side, which is new information. It looks like we're getting a new Prime Battle. If you guys don't know, the Prime Battles are the LR Frieza event and the LR Super Saiyan Goku event, the two OG events. It looks like we may be getting a new one. This is going to be the LR Super Saiyan Trunks event, most likely. That's at least from what these guys are saying down over here. So we'll have to go wait and see what happens. But yeah, that's all the information as of right now. I will be doing more information. I haven't recorded any gameplay on Dragon Ball Legends for you guys. I definitely wanted to do that so that way I had some content for you for Saturday and Sunday. I will probably end up doing that. I'm going to do one video in terms of in-game mechanics, how to maneuver, how to do key blasts, how to do melee and all that other stuff. And then I'll probably hold a separate video for how to navigate through the game, the menus, and everything that's going on. But I do have one soul boost waiting for you guys as well, so that way I can do one on camera. But anyway, guys, that is it. Let me know if I forgot of anything. Let me know what you guys are excited for. Which banners are you going to be summoning on? Are you going to wait for the Super Saiyan or for the 3-year anniversary? Because that is about a month away. Again, I'm not. I'm going in on Bardock because I want that Super Saiyan 3. Bardock, nominal unit. But outside of that, plus I'm a huge fan of Bardock. But outside of that, that's probably going to be the only one I summon on, unless they do something else special, but I don't think they will, with the Tapion banner. But anyway, guys, that's it. Thank you for joining me here today, and I'll catch you all in the comments below. Peace.